Welcome. I am Kirkol, leader of the Fomoas, and it is here today at Nexon that I have come to destroy the irrational ideas of these humans. They think that they have opportunities to rule, and that will never happen while I am here. Welcome to the 11th anniversary of Mapinogi.
Welcome, everybody. I am Chad Hoku of Hoku Props. I'm a prop maker for a living, and I was given the privilege of bringing Kirkol to life. Kirkol is the god of the Fomoars, and he is also kind of the opposing counterpart to Morgan.
So, my name is Linda. I also go by Vampy Bitme. Don't ask me how I get the name. But anyway, my character Morgan is actually a goddess of war, crows, and vengeance. She is loved by everyone, but little do they know that she is super sinister by nature.
I've worked on projects with Vampy in the past. We get along really well. There is really good kind of chemistry between us as far as working on stuff together. There's very little stress, and that's something that's pretty rare. She said, hey, I've got this project that I'm looking for somebody else to work with, and it was Kirkol and Morgan. And anytime I have a chance to work on a project like that, I'm ready. The first thing you do after you go through and see all of the reference art is you figure out what materials it's gonna be made of. So in this case, I wanted to use some leather for these elements, like the belts, and then like the collar piece, as well as all of these raised gold elements. And then the other one that's really important is fabric.
For this Morgan costume, it took me about a good 2 months to make everything. That includes looking for the fabric downtown, making sure that I made the right mock-ups, because you can mess up here and there and you don't want to use good fabric for that.
If you can get a fabric that is kind of period accurate, or it looks good, or, you know, it'll photograph well, you have to make sure that you're kind of taking that into consideration. I work in 3D, so all of these detailed bits and elements, I'll actually design them in 3D, 3D print them, finish them, paint them. From the moment we started making the costume, we had the photo shoot in mind.
For the photo shoot, I really have fun with this one, because for me, it's more so a feeling. It's not even about the costume. Playing the character, it's kind of like my own way of acting. Working with the photographer and the modeler was the most fun part, because we had to figure out from scene to scene what something was gonna look like.
The way that I approach a photo shoot starts with the materials. I wanna make sure that the materials are something that will show well on photo. And so fabrics, you know, we use things like velvet because it has a really nice texture, micro suede, leather as well. Anytime you can use material that has a slight thickness to it, like leather, it allows you to get more detail in the shot. Understand your character, understand the sort of poses that he would take, and then also the kind of elements that you want to portray. And then once you get to the photo shoot, it's actually pretty enjoyable. It's just doing what you've practiced.
The reason I got into cosplay pretty much is from my mom. She used to dress us up, she would just make up costumes, and she'd be like, you're wearing this, and we had to wear it. So that's how I got into cosplay, whatever she just made us wear.
I've been making stuff since I was a kid. Back in 2011, I became a prop maker for a profession. So growing up making things the way that I did with my father, and then also being the inner nerd that I was with all the games and the anime and all the different things that I really enjoyed, I was offered that opportunity to take the two and bridge them.
What is it I like about cosplay? What is there not to like, though? To be real, when I got into cosplay, it was pretty much because I didn't have too many friends in general. I've always been super shy when I was younger, so for me to break out of it, I used cosplay. Just me regularly, I was like, no, I don't know if I can do that. But in cosplay, I was like, yeah, I'm strong, I'm cool.
One of the things that has been so impressive is just how committed the community of Mabinogi are to their game. They love it so much. And the other thing that's been really nice is the fact that they appreciate what we've been doing. And so just having people that are so appreciative of a company that's trying to really give back to their community, it's something that's full circle.
Throughout this whole project, I realized that the Mabinogi fandom is so crazy awesome. When I did stream the Morgan progress on my Twitch, people went nuts. Literally, they were just like, I'm here, you're great, Linda, but I really just want to check out how you're gonna make Morgan, because they all really love her.
So what I would really like to say is thank you. Thank you to the Mabby team for including me in this project. Thank you for the community. You guys are wonderful. You guys have gotten to 11 years, and that's because you guys have worked together to get there.
I want to give a huge shout out to the whole Mabinogi community and the Mabi team for bringing me on this project. Everyone is so passionate in this game, and I'm really excited to see what the future brings for Mabinogi.
Thank you for having us, Nexon. Once again, we had a wonderful time. Bye, everybody.
Bye.